the review. Speaking of, when is the review?
I've been recording for the past 10 seconds.
What was that?
I've been recording for the past 10 seconds.
Hi guys, and welcome to Bobsy Bounce. I am Bobs.
I'm Joe.
And welcome to our new segment today called Bolly Blunders. And today we are going to be reviewing
Zilla, because you're bad.
Right, Joe, so to begin with, what is your verdict on this movie?
I loved it. Absolutely loved this movie. I'm ready to talk about this movie for at least 5 hours.
You serious?
Okay, well, I've got a bit of a concern just to begin with about this movie, guys. First of all, this movie, how long is this movie, by the way, Joe?
Just under 2.5 hours.
Okay, well, it took me about 3 hours or 3.5 hours to watch this because I could only watch it on YouTube. That's the only place I can actually find this. As you guys can see, it's got an advert after every 3 minutes. So this movie took me, and the adverts, which you can't skip either.
No, they're not. You get 2 adverts. So it took me around about 4 hours to watch this movie because I made pages and pages of notes on this movie.
So let's just start off with the plot of the movie, actually.
No, I think they lost the plot.
Yeah, so yeah, basically this movie, it actually has no plot. In fact, did you make some notes on this?
Near the end, near the last page of my notes, I wrote down about an hour and 53 minutes into this movie, I still can't describe what the actual plot of this movie is. And it seemed as though that they've made things up as they go along, a bit like this review.
How dare you? You have stolen my dreams and my childhood with your empty words.
Anyway, so since we can't talk about the plot of the movie, let's talk about some of the characters in the movie.
That's my favourite bit.
So some of the characters, we'll start with Arshad Warsi.
Yep, aka 4G.
Yeah, who probably hasn't made a good movie since
Munna Bhai.
And then we've also got Vivek Oberoi, who plays, what is it?
He plays the same character as he did in Company.
I'm not even a beautiful woman.
And his name in the movie is
Chandu. No, Masterji.
Masterji, that's his name in the movie. We've got our
Sanju Baba.
Yeah. Which, by the way, this is another thing confusing about Sanju. To say that he's plastered all over the posters and everything, he makes his first entry into the movie about 56 minutes into the movie.
Well, it's not really him if you think about it. It's Chubul Pandey version 3.0 that he makes.
Well, actually, saying that, the second time, because he makes quite a few entries in his movie, there's a song that plays. Honestly, guys, what does this song remind you of?
Anything at all.
Anything at all. So Chandrachur Singh is one of my favorite actors. I saw him for the first time in a movie called Tere Mere Sapne. After that, he came in Dark.
The fire.
Or the dog, the flame.
Dog, the lighter.
Dog, the fire. He was in that. And after that, he came.
Josh.
And after Josh, then he lost his hosh. And he, and he came into this movie called Zila Ghaziabad. I'm going to eat you. Ma. You're winning. Keep your thoughts. You're very angry. It's also got Paresh Rawal in the movie as well. He plays the part of like a Thakur Saad kind of a guy.
Yeah, he's like the godfather, you know. So he's channeled, you know, Marlon Brando from The Godfather, or you know, like Joe Pesci from Goodfellas.
And his name in the movie, by the way. You see, all these big actors, like, you know, Joe's mentioning at the moment, all these characters have big names like Don Corleone, and, you know, you've got
The Godfather. The Godfather.
Yeah, you've got all these big names and big characters. His name in the movie is Chairman. So in the movie, he's called the Chairman. But they call him Chairman. Yeah. He has issues with another character called...
He has a clash.
With a character called...
Rashid?
Yeah, Rashid Bhai. Back to the plot of the movie, which we're trying to explain, but it's very difficult to explain.
It's very difficult to explain, yeah. Because, as we said before,
scratch my head,
isn't a plot to actually speak of. Like I said, it's just a string of events that have been glued together, and that's it.
Anyway, we're going to get back to the plot. I just want to talk about the love interest in the movie as well.
Oh.
So the love interest, so this is Germaine's daughter, and she is Master's girlfriend. Mm-hmm. They're destined to be married.
They are destined to be married because he's an overly good guy.
I'll tell you what I really liked, and this shows you that how much they're in love. So Master comes into the house, mm-hmm. has a meeting. As he's leaving the house, all of a sudden, she drops a bucket of water on him from the top. Now, is it mop water? Is it, I don't know what it is. But anyway, she drops
dirty
water
laundry.
On him. So then she, in front of her dad, says, "Chalo, Chalina, let's get you changed." Right? Oh. And her dad's like, "Ah, beta, oh, they're just little kids. Let him just go upstairs." Doesn't get him changed. But when they go upstairs, see, she comes out with a very specific dialogue.
So classy.
So classy.
So classy. Inspired writing.
Script writers should be given an award.
अब आप अपने गीले कपड़े खुद उतारेंगे? या ये काम भी हमें करना पड़ेगा?
Talking more about this actress who shall remain nameless. However, very good actress. This is probably the only movie that we've seen of it.
Yeah, I looked at the IMDb page for my sins because that's what I do in my spare time. This is actually the only movie she's ever made.
So after searching for this, because I was trying to find an interview of this lady, who she is and where she's come from, and I managed to find this interview of hers, and this is what she had to say about her role.
Obviously, I am lucky to be in a film like Jilla Ghaziabad. Very fantastic character. Jilla Ghaziabad is what I feel is a proper launch or a proper film or whatever. I mean, I've got songs. At the end of the day, songs matters a lot. Very fantastic character.
Yeah, so moving on swiftly, guys, because we've literally just covered the first 3 minutes of the movie right now. This is a 2.5 hour long movie that took us about 3 to 4 hours to watch.
Spoiler alert, guys, you know what we've explained in the first 2 minutes of the movie, after 2 hours of the movie...
It gets much worse. What we found at the very start of this movie is that this movie has been inspired by a lot of other Hollywood tricks that they've done.
Stop copying me!
The Matrix?
I'm thinking about Superman.
Okay, so we've got Superman, Matrix,
Star Wars for definite.
This is the problem with Bollywood nowadays. They call it inspiration. They don't call it copying anymore because that's a bad word to use.
I mean, just have a look at this shot. And he's not the only one who's limited or restricted to these powers. No. This is a super village. Should be called Zilla
Avengers Bad.
What else can we talk about more into the plot? There isn't one to talk about. That's the thing, there's no plot.
Basically, there's a lot of misunderstandings, and after the misunderstandings, it turns out that 4G is no longer working for the chairman. He's now working for this Rashid Khari.
Yeah.
I'm trying to be as serious as I can about this movie at the moment because I really don't know. I really don't want to make this into like a really funny thing and make it like, oh, the movie's really bad.
No, I genuinely had a really good time watching this movie. I have to be honest. In fact, I think I even texted you at one point.
And you said, I'm actually enjoying this movie.
I'm actually enjoying this movie a lot.
And I was actually contemplating blocking Joe's number at that point. Moving on with the plot, Master's brother Chandrachu Singh, the legend, gets shot. He dies. What happens at that point is then Master decides now he's going to become a gangster as well. So he becomes a gangster. They start to shoot each other. And at that point is when Sanju Baba makes his entry for the second time or third time. I don't know.
Let me think. He makes his second entry at that time. Now, let me just clarify what we mean by entry at this point. Yeah, this movie is an epileptic nightmare.
Yeah, honestly, guys, you know, if you're going to be watching this movie, if you do suffer from epilepsy, please don't watch this movie. Just be wary of your health. I don't even suffer from epilepsy now.
Put me in a coma.
Yeah.
I'm shutting you down.
Moving on even further, another thing I need to mention actually, before I forget. Throughout the movie, you'll notice that Sanju Dutt, he likes to sit down. I think he's probably in his house. And he's always got a chessboard.
Yeah.
He's got a chessboard and he's drinking alcohol and he's smoking a cig, right? So he's smoking a cig and he's got this shiro shairi, he's got this poetry going on and he's moving the pawns here and there. I didn't quite understand what that meant.
He's a genius.
He didn't show any genius. In fact, there's one part where he drops in on a meeting.
That's brilliant.
So that part where you got all the gangsters of Zilla Ghaziabad, they're in one kind of a warehouse.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, Sanju Dutt turns up.
Yeah, he does. First actual meeting. So you got our main copper and our main gangsters, the first time they're coming head to head. This is like, you know, Robert De Niro and Al Pacino came together for the first time on screen. That level of writing, this is screenwriting and all that channeled into this movie. They came together and this happens.
Daru Sharu Lao, Chamiya ka bandobast karo.
By the looks of it, the police in Ghaziabad have item girls and dancers on their payroll.
Disco lights, they've got somehow all the police officers, they're all synchronized.
No, I want to know that, right? I want to see the deleted scene over here where, you know, like, so a week earlier they've decided, you know, so he's recruiting the dancer, he's recruiting the background dancer.
That'd probably make a better movie than this.
Tanji does they go and 5, 6, 7, 8. My cheeks are...
Sorry guys, Joe's crying.
I've lost the... this movie lost the plot.
Now the ending is probably one of the best endings I've seen.
It is,
guys.
It is, yeah. At the same time, one of the best and the worst scenes I have ever come across.
Everyone's having a gun, everyone's having a shootout, everyone's firing bullets, this, this, that. And then all of a sudden Vivek Oberoi comes.
You know, to say they've got all these superpowers.
Yeah.
They have.
And then in the middle of all of this, of all this shooting and everything, then Sanju Baba comes up.
Oh.
Somehow he can defy the laws of physics.
And then the movie just abruptly ends.
So what actually happens in the ending though?
It just ends.
Guys, we've tried to explain the plot of the movie, right? I think we failed miserably. Either we failed.
No, the movie failed.
I've watched this movie 4 times, guys. I still don't know what is going on. Like you said, it's a series of events which they've just kind of edited together, some songs in there, and they've decided to make it into a movie. Now, the movie, yeah, it just finishes.
So you got all these deadly gangsters. You've got Fauji, you've got Rashid, you've got Jermaine, you've got Master, who becomes a gangster at the end. Out of all these guys, I'm going to give you a guy that has the biggest kill count in the whole movie and breaks the most laws in the whole movie.
Is it not one of the gangsters?
No, it's not. Sanjay Dutt, he breaks the most amount of
laws. He's a police officer though.
So what?
He's just supposed to follow the law.
And not only is he not reprimanded for it at the end, guess what? They gave him a medal. At this point, I just had to, you know, I had to tip my cap to this guy. So guys, in summary, this movie had no plot. The actors overacted. The songs, well. Yeah, those are our thoughts on this movie. And now we've come across a lot of reviewers, qualified reviewers.
Even though we don't have qualifications in
film studies,
right? We still think that we are critics.
Just the way everyone else is.
Yeah. And every critic has
their own rating system.
Their own rating system. Some give it 5 stars, A to Z even.
Mm-hmm. We're going to give it a rating out of 5 samosas. So we're going to give this 2 samosa. No, actually, do you know what? This movie gets 1.5.
It's a very crunchy samosa. This movie gets a 1.5 samosa rating out of 5, of course.
Can I have one?
You are the other trend.
So guys, thank you so much for watching. That sums it up for today. Hope you guys enjoyed that review. There's plenty more reviews to come in the future. If you have any ideas of what reviews you want us to, just leave it in the comments below. And please like, share and subscribe. And also for the future, guys, if you want to be notified of when our next video is going to be uploaded, just please click on the bell icon and you'll be notified when the next video comes out. Okay, guys, thank you once again so much for watching. I am Bobs.
I'm Joe.
Saying good fight.
Good night.